viewers, my name is Muji Adegwite. You're welcome to today's episode of In Depth of Life. And on today's episode, we are talking about motherhood. Motherhood is not just a day job. It's not by mouth. As a mother, you don't have affections or care for your family alone, but also for others. Motherhood is a state of being a mother. The mother gets pregnant and carries it for 9 months. At the first trimester, she goes through a lot, like being feverish, vomiting, and also feeling irritating of different things. After 9 months, she goes into the labor room and bears the child in pain. Thereafter, seeing the child and overwhelmed with joy. During breastfeeding, the mother communicates with the child. That's how you see some child whenever they're sucking their mother's breast. See them smiling, see them laughing. There's a way of communicating with their mother at that tender age. And also the mother also teaches the child how to have affection for others, how to care for others. Some mothers will pinch their child at that early stage or beat them. It's not that they are making the child to feel pain. No, just want to know how the child will feel. Just want to see the kind of expression that the child will bring out. And also, as a mother, your kitchen and your work is not meant to be your main priority, but your home first. Because after the work, you come back home. You can get sacked at any time because the work is not yours. Even if the work is yours, the home should be your main priority. Your home should be your main priority. Your child should be your main priority. You need to give them the time. You need to give them the attention. You need to make them feel at home all the time. You don't need to make them to isolate themselves. You see some parents, they'll be in the sitting room watching television. Their child can be in the room for 10 good hours even without coming to the sitting room. Their child even be in the room eating. They won't even go to their room to check on them that what is going on with their child. Sometimes at that moment, what they need is just to have their private time or just their quiet time. But as a mother, check on them. See them. Just to know if they are doing well. And as a mother, you should always try to make them happy, but not get them spoiled. Always scold the child. Don't beat them always. Sometimes as a child, what they need is just advice. What they need is sweet talks. What they need is to stroll out with you, have some time with you, have some fun with you, and also feel free to tell you anything. As a mother, you don't need to always be like a masquerade to your child. Don't imbibe too much fear in them. Don't make them to be scared of telling you things. Don't make them to be scared of expressing their thoughts and happiness to you. Some child, even when something happens to them, they are always scared to go to their mom. Why? Because they be like, what will mommy say? How will mommy feel if I tell her this thing? But if from the foundation, you've created that atmosphere, you've created that attention and care for her or for him or her, that thought will not come. Also, as a mother, you need to give the child the listening ears. You need to allow the child to be able to confide in you. If they can't confide in you, they move out to friends or to teachers. And they don't know what it takes to be a mother. And they don't know the meaning of motherhood. And they don't know the in-depth of motherhood. Like a story I heard sometimes ago, the child, whenever a mother comes back from work, she calls her attention. Mom, I want to see you. Mom will say, my dear, I'm very tired. Then I just came back from work. Okay. I'll see you tomorrow morning. Before she wakes up in the morning, her mom is off to work. Not knowing that the child is being abused by her father at the early stage of 6. It went on like that. When the child could not bear these pains again, she went ahead to see her teacher. That was at the age of 10. You can imagine things like that's 4 years. Not only she went to meet her teacher, because her teacher was a victim of that. All she could advise is for her to always drink, because that was what she was also doing at that age when she was in that position too. So she advised her to always take alcohol, at least to ease the pain and to take the thinking off. It went on and on and on like that. At the age of 16, her mother got to know there's something wrong with the child. But it was too late for her because she was already an addict. It was too late for her because her daughter was no longer who she knew. So as a mother, you need to create that time. You need to create the attention for your child. You need to know them. You need to, even if they cannot express things with you, even if they are scared, call them. Bring them close. My dear, how are you? How was your day today? Even if you come back from work around 9 p.m., go to their room and check on them. Don't just go straight to your room. even when you're back from work, but you go to work as early as possible just to make ends meet. You need to check on them. You need to allow them to know that, yes, they are being loved. Yes, I can share my thoughts with my mom or my dad. I can share my thoughts with also my friend, but not just my friend now, but my mom. My mom should be my best friend. You need to create a friendship relationship with your children. They should be free to tell you things. Also make them happy always, but do not spoil them. As a mother, always scold the child. Don't always beat them. Sometimes what the child needs is to just call them close, talk some sense into their head. As a mother, at a teenage age of 13, you need to start giving the child the freedom. You need to start giving the child privacy. The privacy of she have her room, he have her own room. Whenever you want to go into the inside his or her room, you need to knock the door. That is not spoiling the child, but it's to building them of how life is. Knock and get permission before you enter into the room. If he or she says, "Mommy, I'm busy," don't say, "Ah, omo iti baje. Ah, ola keti pomo ije. Ah, ye iti baje." No, it's not like that. The child is not spoiled. That is how we can train the child. You need to allow them to start having privacy at a teenage age. Don't give your female child that thinking of, if you move close to a guy, if you move close to a male, you'll get pregnant. If a male touches you, you get pregnant. No, we know beyond that, the world is not civilized now. If you don't tell them the truth, they will learn it outside. Even some, their brain is so sharp that they know everything, but they expect to hear from you. But they don't hear it from you, they learn it outside. And at the end of the day, they bring it back at the, they bring it back to us in a way we don't expect. As a mother, you don't have to always send them away whenever they're showing immoral things on television stations. Don't always let them to get used to Cartoon Network or Nickelodeon. Some child, when you see them watching Cartoon Network, all the songs that is there, they will memorize everything. Even as a mother, you don't even know what is going on there. Don't allow them to always watch Cartoon Network. Or let them know what is going on other television stations. They know it, but because all you do is, I want to come over Yoruba movie. No, it shouldn't be just Cartoon Network. Let them watch it. Let them learn it at home. When they are kissing, tell them they are kissing. It's meant for an adult. It's meant for husband and wife. This is what they are doing. Let them learn it in your presence. Let them learn it at home. Their brains are very, very sharp. You see this young sharp out there? Their brains are very, very sharp. I went to visit someone some weeks back, and we were watching the TV. The next thing the boy said is, "Please change the station, they're about to kiss." How did you know they're about to kiss? You see, they know everything, but you think they don't know it. If you don't teach them at home, they will go outside and learn it. They will watch it outside and they start putting it into practice. But as a mother, you tell them what they're about to have, they're about to kiss, they're about to have sex. Don't be scared to hear from them. Don't be scared to tell them the truth, because that truth, they know it. As you always say, that truth is bitter. But at that tender age, they know it. They want to hear from you. But if they ain't such a thing for me at that tender age, with time, they will know what it means. You don't always need to nag on your children. You don't always need to ask them silly questions like, "Where are you going? Where are you coming from? Who is he? Who is she? Taninye?" Don't do that. Welcome them. Embrace them. Even in their presence, let them feel at home. When they leave, you can ask, "Ah, who is that one to you? Oh, or is it your boyfriend?" You create some atmosphere that the girl will be free with you, that your daughter will see you as a friend. You create a relationship, a friendship relationship within you and your child. Don't make it to be like scold all the time. All those things scares the children away from the mother. It does not allow them to confide in their mother, because they will be scared of what will come out of them. They will be scared of what the outcome will be. For more information, contact us on the number and the email address on your screen. Thank you for watching today's episode on In Depth of Life. See you same time, same channel next week. Don't enjoy this alone. Share with your friends and also tell them to subscribe to Drasheg TV. My name remains Muchi Adegbite.